Welcome to another example of solving a system of nonlinear equations. We want to find all of the solutions to the system 2x squared minus y squared equals 23 and x squared plus 2y squared equals 34. We'll first solve this system algebraically using substitution or elimination, and then we'll verify the solution graphically. In the first two examples, we solved the systems using substitution, so for this problem we'll use elimination or the addition method, which means we want to add the two equations together to eliminate either the x squared terms or the y squared terms. For this example, let's focus on eliminating the y squared terms. So we want the coefficients of the y squared terms to be opposites. Well, right now in the first equation, we have negative 1y squared, and the second equation we have 2y squared. They're already opposite signs, but we want the y squared term in the first equation to be negative 2y squared, so we're going to multiply this first equation by positive 2, and we'll leave the second equation the same. So if we multiplied the first equation by positive 2, we would have 4x squared minus 2y squared equals 2 times 23 is 46. We'll leave the second equation the same. Now I do want to mention, to use the elimination method for a nonlinear system, we do want to make sure the degree of the y terms are the same, meaning both of them are y squared in this case. If one was y and one was y squared, we would not be able to eliminate the y terms. So now we'll add these two equations together. Notice when we do this, the y squared terms are opposites, so they'll add to 0. So we'll have 5x squared equals 46 plus 34 is equal to 80. To solve this for x, we'll first divide by 5 on both sides. So we have x squared equals 80 divided by 5 is equal to 16. At this point, we should recognize we'll have two values of x that satisfy this equation. Since we have x squared and we want x, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation, and we'll include a plus or minus sign here to make sure we obtain both solutions. So the square root of x squared is equal to x. It's actually the absolute value of x, another reason why we have two solutions. And then the square root of 16 is equal to 4, so x equals either positive or negative 4 or plus or minus 4. And now to find the corresponding values of y that give us the solutions for the system, we'll perform back substitution. Let's go ahead and use the first equation here to find the corresponding values of y. So if we use the equation 2x squared minus y squared equals 23, let's first solve this for y squared. So we're actually going to add y squared to both sides and subtract 23 on both sides. That would give us 2x squared minus 23 equals y squared. Let's go ahead and switch this around. We have y squared equals 2x squared minus 23. And now we know that x can be either positive 4 or negative 4. Let's substitute x equals positive 4 first to find the corresponding values of y. So we would have y squared equals 2 times 4 squared minus 23. So we have y squared equals 4 squared is 16. 16 times 2 is equal to 32. Well, 32 minus 23 is equal to 9. So we have y squared equals 9. So again, to solve for y, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation. We'll have two solutions, one positive and one negative. And since the square root of 9 is equal to 3, we'll have y equals plus or minus 3. So from this outcome, we know we have at least two solutions. When x is positive 4, y can be either positive 3 or negative 3. So this would be one solution. And the second solution would be 4, negative 3. Remember, when giving the solution as ordered pairs, the first coordinate is always the x coordinate or x value, and the second coordinate is the y coordinate or y value. Remember, we also said that x can be negative 4, so using this equation again, we'll substitute negative 4 for x. So we would have y squared equals 2 times negative 4 squared minus 23. Well, negative 4 squared is equal to positive 4 squared. So if we simplify this, we're going to get y squared equals 9 again. So if we take the square root of both sides of the equation, again we'll have y equals plus or minus 3. So this outcome gives us two more solutions. When x is negative 4, y can be positive 3 or negative 3. So the third solution would be negative 4 comma 3, and the fourth solution would be negative 4 comma negative 3. So this system actually has four solutions given by these ordered pairs. And to verify this, we're going to graph both equations on the same coordinate plane, and our graphs should intersect at these four points. Let's take a look. The first equation is actually a hyperbola in red, and the second equation is actually an ellipse in blue. Notice how we do have four points of intersection, 1, 2, 3, 4, where in the first quadrant, the point of intersection is 4, 3. In the second quadrant, the point of intersection is negative 4, 3. In the third quadrant, the intersection is negative 4, negative 3. And finally, in the fourth quadrant, the intersection is 4, negative 3. So these four points of intersection verify that our solution is correct. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.